Aaron, we've got to meet up today, so we've got to go meet them guys at our YouTube. 2 o'clock. We've got to meet there at 2. Put your trackers on and that. Bring some poles.
I like the sport boxing. I always wanted to do kickboxing since I was little. You know, something like that, kickboxing, kung fu. You know, I just watch a lot of Bruce Lee and stuff like that, Jackie Chan. But then my dad knew Martyn Lynch from Middleton, my amateur trainer. And he took me there when I was 14 in Middleton, such a boxing gym in Middleton. And when I walked there, I never knew nothing out of boxing, I had to punch, nothing. But I always liked fighting, I always tried fighting, me and Martyn always tried fighting, my brother. And he taught me, I just fell in love with it. I used to love football, I don't even watch football anymore. I don't like boxing them. So.
And what was your first memories, could you recall, of walking in that gym, you know, smelling that?
It was scary, walking in that, everyone looking at you, thinking, oh, new meeting, new person here. It's just scary walking, and first spar was the worst, first sparring. When you learn how to jab, throw a straight shot, and then you come in and spar, and you're getting knocked all around the ring by someone better than you. But I won't change that, because that got me better, that got me good. I'm not getting that, I used to be, I'm not sparring, not this again the next day, but it's got me to where I am today, so can't complain.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it, you know, it's never easy boxing, it's not an easy game, you know. And what does it take to do it every day? And, you know, it's the hardest game of all, to you keep
just
coming and doing
it. If you want to make a living out of it, that's what I do. I do. I eat, sleep and breathe boxing. I do everything. Train twice a day every day. That's the right foods, supplements, everything. So I'm proper dedicated, and that's what you have to be to make it in this game. Right? After all the skill work was done, we said, oh, that's the first light spar we've had with someone else out of the club. It's fine, it's your but like Pat said, it gets awkward, it gets hard, because we know what we're going to do. So I'm wary, people are going to count me, I'm going to do the same, I'm waiting to count with them. So when we do it with someone else, they don't know anything about us out of the box. So that was the first one, so it was quite hard, but enjoyed it. That's what I need.
You're sparring with the lads all the time in here, and you know, you're obviously friends and all that.
Yeah,
sometimes probably hard to open up or try things that you know. Sparring there with Jimmy Kelly, he's a new professional.
Yeah,
an open
he's well known in the amateurs as well, Jimmy.
Yeah, he's
a good fighter. He fought for England and all that. He's all right, lad.
Good amateur. You actually met him yourself, didn't you? Was it your 49 fight? You said,
yeah. 49 fight, I fought for him. Yeah.
How did you get on with Jimmy in that
one? I lost by points, it was a close fight, but I think he just pinched it. Yeah. It was a close fight.
So the rematch there.
There you go, left hand up, good man. Oh, jab, jab,
second of September this month, your second pro fight. You know, you're looking forward to that.
Yeah, definitely. Can't wait to get out of that. My last fight was in February, so I'm just dying to get out again. So after my first fight, I was like, pat, when's my next one? I want to get in again, I want to get out, get on, get in the next fight. But I was meant to fight in the 80th of May, but I've done my wrestling, so I'll come back to that.
It's got to be important, hasn't it? You've got to be regular fighting.
Yeah, I want to keep busy to get up the ladder quicker, get known, get title fight quicker, but perhaps not going to rush up that. It's going to keep me low under the radar, you know, keep me local shows, get me experience up, and then put me in for a title fight. That's all the mistake these British fighters make. They go in too early for a title fight, and then where they go from there, they don't learn anything, they've got enough experience to go to the next stage. So.
Too willing to, you know, learn the trade, get on these small shows often as you can, and
yeah,
you know,
get a good following from the club. When I go do fight somewhere far, I'll get a good fan base to come with me.
There you go. There you go. There, you see that backhand, no? The backhand's not coming from there. And it strikes from there. I've not seen that shoulder turn and back. Thank you.
stage is he at the moment, and how's his training been going for this fight?
His training's been going well. The only thing that he's not been doing, he lacks sparring. Yeah. And time, that'll do. And that's the only thing that he lacks now, is a lot more of what he did today. And if I can get him sparring more, I mean, that's the first spar he's had properly throughout the season. He's okay sparring with the likes of lads that we've got in the gym. But it doesn't do him no justice because they're all being taught by the same trainer. So they're all wary, waiting to counterpunch each other. And when you can get fresh sparring with someone that they don't know, and they don't know, it's kind of like a fight. They've got to use this part now, the brain. They've got to start thinking in there now. And that's what I need more. I need them to be a lot more creative, to do a lot more. And Matthew Ryan, as you know, when he actually fights, he's 10 times better than you watch him in the gym. Yeah. You get some kids that look brilliant in the gym. But when they're in the ring, you know, they feel wow. I mean, I've had fighters like that before. But this kid here, when you actually watch him fight, he's a total different fighter. But there's all the learning there. He can get caught with shots, silly shots, he can get beat. But in a fight, it will be different. He won't get caught with them silly mistakes because he would have cleaned up. And that's where it counts. Forget about the gym. He might look, he can look like he's being had off in the gym. I don't care. It's what he's learned from that. And it's what he's learned from it in a fight, that's where it matters. And it will not happen to him in a fight. It's very hard to predict the future. But, you know, I'll tell you this now, on a domestic level, he'll win a British title. Easy. Yeah. After that, it's where he wants to go. The world is always with these young kids. You know, the difference with these young kids is there's too many obstacles along the way. Now, if he stays focused and he stays on the right path, then he can go all the way. He can definitely go all the way. I mean, he's got the making, he's got the right attitude, he's a lovely lad. I mean, and there isn't many like him. If I had everyone like him, yeah, then I would have all champions.
You know, we're here at the Collyhurst and Moston. There's a lot of history, you know, behind this gym, and you know, you're following the paths of some quality fighters who have come through here. One of them is Pat himself.
Definitely.
And Tommy, obviously, and to train here with them and to for them to pass the knowledge on to you. You know, you must it must be good for you.
Yeah, definitely, it's good. I have to assess. Pat's the strict one, Tommy's the mess about one, but it's a good combination because you need that laughter and banter in the gym when you're training. Then you come in, you know, on top, it's boring, you can't push yourself when you have that laughing and that competition against each other. Makes you push yourself in training, but we are good now. Good team, Pat and Tommy.
Coming in for years, but recently coming seeing you lads, you've all got a really close bond, haven't you?
Yeah,
and, you know, it's a real good team spirit.
It's good bond. It's, like I said, it's competitive. We have competitiveness. We're running on Wednesdays. We do have competitive against each other. Like, if someone sprints off someone, you have to catch him. Or if someone hits me, right, I have to hit him with more shots. Another shots I need to overdo. So it is good. But we have all got a good bond, and that's what you need in the gym.
And do you socialise out of the gym?
Yeah, with that one weekend, we started going running together, like me, Lyndon, and Tack. I've not run with him yet, I was going to go this weekend, but I'm going to go. and we do it in Ardley Edge. They've done it twice now in Ardley Edge, so I'm going to go for my son at 6:30 in the morning.
You live, sleep and breathe the game.
Yeah, run it, train every morning, run every night, and the only rest day I have is Sunday out of the top training.
And if you know, in a perfect scenario, if you could plan your future out, you know, what is that? What is your future hold for?
Future of me, just doing, enjoying what I'm doing, and make it big in boxing. Make myself a world champion. Make me fans out there, mate, and my family out there. And my dad, who's rest in peace, has gone now, who's got me into the sport. So I'm going to do it for him as well. I promised him on his deathbed that I'd be good for him, so I'm going to do it for him as well.
He was your inspiration and your influence.
Yeah, he got me into it. He made me go when he said, I want to do boxing. I don't like boxing. I want to do some of my kicks and everything. But he said, come on, you'll like it, come on. And he knew the club. I thank you for that, because made me the person I am today.
And when it does get tough and them long runs and hard training sessions and obviously these hard fights.
Yeah, just think of him, push me.
Dad's memory gets you.
Yeah. Next step is just to keep winning, keep up what I'm doing, keep boxing, keep using the ring. Make it to a good title fight, because of the British scene, and they're all one dimension. You know, do one thing, like straight and sort of walk forward. But Pat's like working with us, had loads of different styles, loads of different movements, make us better, and that's how he's training us. Like, we're already going for a title fight. So by the time we do this title fight, we'll be ready, we'll have to change nothing but get fit off.
And you know, the background you had in boxing, since you've come here, do you feel you've come on leaps and bounds again, gone to the next level?
Definitely. I've learnt a lot, come on a lot, even the family scene, the first pro fight, you know, not to pass it in, can't believe how much he's changed, you've changed him, you're a fighter. And so, I was known as a brawler in the amateur. I always brawled, I like brawling, but since I've come here, I've learnt how to spot, so it's totally different, a different thing. Pat's learned me how to use my jab, use the ring, and use my straight shots, and use my mind, most importantly. So, I have learned a lot. Come on.
Watching your, you know, spar on the bags and all that, I wouldn't have thought you was a brawler, really. You know,
No, that's not me. I've changed. Since I come here, I've changed. I've just popped in. Like, sometimes when I'm sparring, I do get into the brawling, because I like to brawl, and I'm good at fighting inside, and now I'm good at boxing. But, so that's good for me in this British scene, because I can fight and brawl. I mean, I can brawl and box. So if I'm boxing, and then I know I'm beating, and just if he comes in for a fight, I'll give him a bit. Get back to boxing.
It's important that, you know, a good pro boxer can adapt to different styles, different scenarios.
You need that in the boxing, because one dimension, you know, you're going to work out at the end of the day what it's going to do. Who's going to work out, you're going to, what it's going to throw in. So if you can change it, then you never know what you're going to throw. It won't know where I'm coming from, where I'm going to throw. So.
There you go. One jab, no good. See, someone like Robbie, you got double it. There you go. Take that number away. And again, back on it yourself. There you go again. Ladies and jab, one jab. Double it, Robbie. Both one shot. There you go. There again, back on it again.
I want to make it past British champion. I want to be full down in history.